Powell taking the Raptors this time against your Bucks. After the Bucks took a 2-0 lead, Kendrick asked out of the bet for $500,
yep,
which you accepted, Nick, and you invited him one last bet into the NBA Finals.
Yeah, and Will, we got to have the final set. I tried to be a good sport here. He got out a little cheap. He bought out of the bet. There's no problem there. I don't know how I feel about this Photoshop. You guys went from making me 108 pounds to 240 pounds. I'm not quite sure why. I'm skinny fat. You've got me just actually fat in this picture. But that's all right. See, I think I did the right
thing. I see you counting that money with the whitest hands in America. I see that.
Long fingers, too. Whose body is this? Regardless, I think I did the right thing.
I found another guy in the building.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I could have held Kendrick's feet to the fire. I let him out cheap.
That was nice.
It was nice. Yeah. Absolutely.
Let me tell you something. Your bookie's not doing that for you, though.
No.
He's not calling you up saying, hey, Nick.
No, he's not.
You know something? Not a good weekend, bro. I happen to know that guy.
Bucks plus three. Just hit the game winner, Kawhi. We all win. You win and I win.
Stories.
Lose by six in double overtime.
Stories.
Gotta be kidding me.
Yep.
Janet,
my bookie's still slapping people.
Stories to start your morning sponsored by Gillette Clear Gel. Cowboys have been hinting all offseason long at who they want to pay and when. Ezekiel Elliott's on that list. And while he might be due for a payday, he does not seem too concerned about it at the moment, saying, quote, I think we have a lot of promise for this season. Chris Carter, are the Cowboys set up to take another step forward after winning a playoff game last year?
They should. What I'm going to talk about is their offense, because I believe the Travis Frederick, their all-pro center coming back, him being 75 to 80%. Stink talks about that immune disorder that he had before. Randall Cobb is a slot receiver. I believe that they're better. Another year with that offensive line, Zeke and Dak with Amari Cooper, they're better. So, yes, one more step this year, Jenna.
And a step forward meaning they can be better than they were last year. Not necessarily that they will take a step further in the playoffs, which would be the conference championship game, even though obviously that's the hope in Dallas.
Step back to where they were a couple years ago where that offense controlled the game.
Right, maybe get home field advantage going through Dallas.
Yes.
Now, the number one thing they need to do this year is improve their goal line inside the 10-yard offense. Warren Sharp laid it out.
Right.
By, as far as effectiveness inside the 5 or the 10, they were bottom 2 in the NFL throughout last season. That should never happen with that running back and that offensive line. So that's where they need to get better.
Hire me as a consultant. I can fix that.
No problem.
To golf now. Brooks Koepka won the PGA Championship over the weekend. It was his 4th major win of his career. All coming in the last 3 years. See, is Koepka the next big star in golf?
Absolutely. If you like long and straight, that's the way he does it. Beat Tiger Woods on Thursday and Friday by 17 shots. Jenna, I know you said he won the tournament yesterday, but no, he didn't. When he was eyeballing Tiger and they were playing together and he whooped him by 17, this tournament was over. So, yes, he prepares for the big events. He's not going to win 30 or 40 tournaments because that's not the way. But this little bodybuilder, Jenna, he likes doing squats and everything. People have criticized him so much for his weightlifting. Now he is a multi-champion. Watch out. He will be in the top 5 for a long time.
He won it on Thursday and Friday. Damn near lost it on Sunday as Dustin Johnson made a surge as he had 4 consecutive bogeys. He was able to hold him off. Listen, Brooks Koepka now has as many majors as Rory. He is one off Phil Mickelson's career with 5 majors. So, and he's done it all in the last 2.5 years. He's been unbelievable. And he is one of the majors he didn't win in the stretch of the Masters. He finished tied for second in that one. He is the surest bet in golf right now.
Yeah, golf has so many great golfers under the age of 32. So if Tiger was to pass Jack Nicklaus or tie him as far as majors, it would be a major accomplishment because there are so many major winners that are currently playing on tour.
Tiger was not making the cut in this one. On to the Lakers. According to reports, they will not replace Magic Johnson with a new president of basketball operations, leaving Rob Pelinka in charge, well, of the franchise, of trying to pitch free agents, of trying to trade for Anthony Davis, of a whole host of things. See, what do you make of the decision here?
This is about power and strength. I think last week, Nick, you talked about, because there was an article out, and you talk about basketball operations are general managers, president hires. They come either from 2 different categories.
Right, well, the head coaching hires. The head coaching hires.
Yes.
Where you are going to empower the head coach, or where you are hiring the head coach to solidify your own power.
Right, so in Rob Pelinka, Isaiah doesn't want to talk about it because he doesn't want to be going on the record of saying someone told him. But I've heard, and Nick has heard, that Magic, when he went to Jenny Buss to talk about what they were trying to do, it was a conversation about the head coach and about Rob Pelinka. And Magic wanted to be able to make some adjustments. So he wasn't allowed to do that. That's why they had the press conference where he said, I'm out of here. And now moving forward, this is about Rob Pelinka and his relationship with Jenny Buss. It's her call. It's not Rob Pelinka's call. It's Jenny Buss's call. So what they have done, they put the Lakers flag on Rob Pelinka, yep. And that's why they've empowered him. That's the reason why they're not going to hire someone over. How can it be his team, his front office, to hire someone that he would be working for or reporting to? So the Lakers are in a tough spot. Now, a lot of people believe that one free agent would be able to change this, but I don't believe that. Because I believe, as I look through this playoffs, and I look at the back of the roster, and how coaches are having to go to the back of that roster, yep, to try to get a win, to make lineup changes, who do the Lakers have that's going to get me? Okay, I need a guy that's going to shoot strictly from the corner. Oh, okay. I need a guy that is a great defensive point guard. Oh, okay, let's go get him. That part right there, Jenna, I don't have a bunch of confidence.
Midseason acquisitions. How big's Nikola Mirotic been in these playoffs for Milwaukee? How big was Mark Gasol in the previous round and last night, for that matter, for Toronto? Yeah. Like, how big was Enes Kanter for Portland prior to this series? It is in the details, right?
Yes.
And so that when you're up, the Lakers need another star to get in the room. They need to fill out the rest of the roster to be the front of the class or have a chance at it. Because none of these teams are doing it with just their star power. We are seeing Malcolm Brogdon, who might be a star one day. But hell, Pat Connaughton,
yes,
from the Bucks is giving them real minutes. You're seeing these, not even secondary.
Lopez.
Right, Brooke Lopez.
He changed their team.
Who walked out the door for the Lakers. They didn't want him. You're seeing these tertiary pieces become major roles, in major players in the playoffs. And you're seeing a team, Toronto, that doesn't, those guys aren't stepping up. They're struggling. So, yeah, that's going to be on Rob Pelinka. And wooing the next free agent is going to be on Rob Pelinka. And convincing the Pelicans to make a trade for Anthony Davis is going to be on Rob Pelinka. I can say this so often. I am process over results. And what bothers me so much about the Lakers here is they didn't fire Magic. If they had decided organizationally, we do not need a president of basketball ops and a GM. Mm-hmm. While I might disagree with it, I would that's their, yeah, prerogative.
You're really into the flow chart, job responsibility, who reporting to who.
I'm into the fact that the Lakers, until Magic said, I ain't going to be here, he had jobs to do.
Yes.
He, without telling anyone, walked out the door. And the Lakers, in their infinite wisdom, decided, well, all those jobs will go to someone who already has a job.
Yes, but we're hearing that the rumor of why he perhaps walked out the door is because Jeannie Buss wasn't allowing him to do all those jobs, like maybe fire the coach. Well, he was smiling. He was being Magic Johnson, which is what we've said is how you're going to go out and get free agents, by being Magic Johnson. Maybe she thought that Rob Pelinka could do all the busy work.
There were responsibilities. No, even if Magic had a lighter workload than the average president of basketball office.
Yes.
There were things that were on his daily plate that now flow to other people.
Mm-hmm.
To have, we have two lead producers on the show, Ketta and Pepper. If Ketta just quit one day and they're like, hey guys, after a month's search, we're not hiring anyone. Pepper's just gonna do both jobs. It's like, wait, what? Like, no, we wanted that job. We thought it was an important job. And then all of a sudden, we're just going to say, no, not that important. One guy can do both. And it's not like Rob Pelinka is R.C. Buford. It's not like he's got this long track record of running basketball.
So why do you think they did it this way? Do you think it's because Jeannie and Rob Pelinka had a conversation and he convinced her he could do it?
I think it's Rob Pelinka and the Rambi consolidating power.
Well, let me tell you what this is. I know you guys didn't grow up in an environment like I grew up in.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up in the housing project. And typically in the housing project, you know everyone's business that's typically in your unit. That anyone your building is connected to, you know who's having trouble in school, who's having marital problems, all those types of things, man. That's what this is about, man. Like, this is a family dysfunction. Now we saw it. Like, that's all there, a dysfunctional family. And we're trying to explain, hey, Mom, you know, don't worry about that. We're trying to make sense of the craziness that the Lakers. This is one of the greatest sports institutions we have seen over the last 50 years. And people are missed on. They have missed the playoffs 6 years in a row. They've lost as many games as the Knicks. Like, they got a real problem. We can't make sense of their stupidity. They are not going upward and onward. Rob Pelinka was a surprise when they hired him the first time.
Right.
And now Magic goes out the door. Nick, you're right. They need people to be able to divide up these responsibilities, regardless of even what you think about Magic. I think the job is too big for this person.
We thought Rob might be in over his head with the one job. He now has as much power as anyone in the NBA. Okay.
All right, well, we'll see what this means as far as landing.
I think they're going to hire Kobe.
They need.
I'm serious. I'm telling you.
No.
I'm telling you. I think they're going to hire
Kobe. I could see that happening. Coming up, can Kawhi take the Raptors all the way to the finals? That's next. First things first.
Don't worry, guys. Linda Rambis and Jason Kidd got this thing covered.